Hello, I'm Neil. Welcome back to the Happy Hearts. This is the Dad Delivers vlog, where we try to be happy with what we've already got. And we've already got this. It's an Amazon Kindle, but we're not happy with it because look, it has bricked. It has completely tanked. It has stopped working. It's a Kindle Paperwhite, and nothing removes this horrible icon of doom, gloom, and death. Is this device dead? I'm going to try and fix this using only my laptop. And if this has happened to you too, I'm so sorry. We've only had this like 2 years, but there might be a way to fix this. My Kindle, it's actually my wife's Kindle, but her Kindle is only showing a battery icon with a exclamation mark. As you can see, I don't think you can see in the daylight, there is a nice battery charging light, but nothing happens. It doesn't turn green and it just stays dead. It's completely bricked. This Kindle has just stopped working. So thanks for coming along with the ride of the Jeopardy with me. So this is my wife's Amazon homepage. I've obviously blanked out some crucial details because goodness forbid that you would actually order some stuff for us. Probably do less damage than we do with it. If I zoom in, on the left-hand side, you can see this hamburger menu icon, the three lines in a row there. That indicates this menu. And if I scroll down, you can see digital content and devices. I'm going to go down to Kindle e-readers and books. I'll click on that, but I'm going to go all the way down to manage your content and devices. Now this has opened up the list of books on my wife's dead Kindle. I wonder if all of these books might have crashed this Kindle. I'm going to remove the ones that I know she's not going to read. So let's try this one and this one. I've selected just two random books, and I'm hoping changing the account will somehow force Amazon to try and contact this device. So if I hit delete here, and this deletes them from my wife's Kindle's library. By the way, you get to see a little glimpse into mine and my wife's reading history. Yeah, make of this what you will. Whoa, the next thing I need to do is to come indoors. This is where I've got Wi-Fi connection to the Kindle. And the next thing we need to do is to press and hold down the power button for a long time. So I'm gonna try that and see if that somehow reboots it. And let go of the power button. No, this didn't work at all. What a waste of time. Okay, so that didn't work. But there's another solution that apparently does work and it means that I'll be slightly less grumpy. And it involves plugging this into your computer to charge it up rather than into a wall socket. If you plug in your Kindle to your computer, it charges at a different voltage. And if you leave it on charge for about half an hour in a computer, sometimes that helps if you can hold down the power reset button for about 45 seconds. And we've got the charge light on, so that's a good sign. I'm going to leave this for half an hour. So we just got back from the park, and you will never guess what's happened. I haven't got my microphone on. I think you can guess what happened. It worked. It's brought the Kindle back to life. Yeah, look, by plugging it into a computer, it charges it at a different voltage. There's some kind of block from using a wall charger. So while my family are arguing about whether an Asus Chromebook is a mum computer, I will celebrate the fact that I have somehow managed to fix her Kindle. There's all kinds of rows kicking off here now. If this has helped you, please hit a thumbs up so that other people can find this video too. And if it hasn't, leave a comment, because I'm sure people down below will be able to help you with your broken Kindle. Oh man, I've got bolognese on the back of my Paperwhite.
Can you please help my daddy get 1,000 subscribers? Just click on his face. Thanks, bye. How was that?